Well, Tish, the hour of parting is near.
Look, they're French! Stop the car!
Uncle Paul just rattled his chains! No fear, no fear!
What a lovely thing to say.
It's cozy.
Tish, the hour of parting is near. To leave this room.
Yes, it has its own quiet elegance.
It's so you.
So us, Gomez.
Lurch, he was always so sentimental.
Playing our song. Darling, I bought you a going away present.
Tish! An umbrella. You know me like a book.
I was afraid the weather might turn nasty, and you know how miserable sunshine can be. I shall pray for clouds.
Maybe a little thunder and lightning.
Remember our honeymoon? That heavenly place?
Who could forget Death Valley?
Darling, your present.
Oh, yes, my present. It's nicely ventilated. How do I look?
You'd look wonderful in anything, mon cher.
Mon cher, Tish, that's French. What French does to me? It turns my blood to hot, bubbling muscatel. Tish, speak some more. Soup du jour, Eiffel Tower, anything. I'll be right back. Bad timing thing, but thanks anyway. Tish, the Lodge Committee is reminding me not to be late. Will you be proud of me when I'm a grand exalted serpent?
Of course, Gomez, darling. But I'm proud of you the way you are. A first-class snake.
First-degree snake.
Thank you, Zing. Darling. Isn't that sweet? The children are playing hide and boo with Uncle Fester.
3 7/16, ready or not, here I come!
Aye, aye, accent free!
No fair! Uncle Sausage rattled his chains! No fair, no fair, no fair!
Calma, Uncle Fester, calma. Uncle Faustus, did you rattle your chains? Uncle Faustus, he likes his little jokes. This time, Uncle Faustus will stay out of it. Won't you, Uncle Faustus? You see? You may start counting, Uncle Fester.
This time I'll count in Swahili. Okay, go hide.
I think your brother handled that beautifully.
Tisha, worried.
About Pancho?
No, no, not about Pancho. He's an Adams. He knows the code of honesty, loyalty, fidelity. I trust him. It's his blood I don't trust. There's a saying, Tish. Beware the brother who once courted your wife.
I have a feeling you made up that saying yourself.
Of course I made it up. I like to be close to the source. Tish, why? Why, oh, why did you invite him?
Because this is the season, my love. And we decided to invite only family this year, remember? And a brother certainly qualifies as family. Besides, I'm sure Pancho's hot blood has cooled off.
You forget, Tish, he's an Adams.
Trust me, Gomez. Yes, Lurch. Take Mr. Adams' luggage downstairs, please.
Yes, Mrs. Adams.
Lurch always was a handy fellow, my dear.
Good legs, too.
Time, Morticia. Stiff upper leaf. That's better. Here.
Thumbs up, Charles.
Morticia, I've never been away during Halloween season before. Do you think I'm being too selfish?
Never, Gomez. You've wanted to be a serpent all your life. You've worked hard for it.
You're right. I've been an ordinary snake long enough. I shall return.
Oh, dear. Lurch has got his pterodactyl net out again. Oh, man, he does it every Halloween.
Well, with some people, it's Santa Claus. At least pterodactyls are his only aberration.
Yes. But how do you tell someone you love that this is the 20th century and pterodactyls are an endangered species?
I hate to leave all these treasures.
Nikita, Lindsay's favorite teddy bear. And who can forget Cousin Ahab's famous last words? Don't give up the fish.
Tish! My trains. My trains. Don't let Pancho near my trains, please.
I promise, mon cher.
Mon cher! That's French! Tish! Speak some more. Bouillabaisse. Cul-de-sac. Charles de Gaulle. Anything.
It's either this or give up becoming the grand exalted serpent.
This.
Are you willing to remain a first-class snake forever?
First-degree snake.
Mother Frump.
Mother got a hold of an old broom and fly recipe. She hopes to be flying by Halloween.
It'll be good to have one of the family in the air again.
Don't torture yourself, Gomez. You've already said goodbye to the children.
One last glance.
Ah, niece and nephew. Playing your innocent childhood games. Children, where is Uncle Fester?
We buried him, Uncle Pancho.
Ah. Good. Where?
In here someplace.
Children, have you forgotten the family motto? You must never bury anybody without leaving a marker.
She's taken over already, even the family motto.
Here he is.
Pugsley, isn't that a little deep?
Speak a little louder, Uncle Fester!
Tell us a story, Uncle Pancho.
Very well, children. Better hurry and dig yourself out, Uncle Fester. I'm going to tell the legend of Cousin Shy.
He's telling the legend. He's wearing my suit.
Here we go, kids. Everybody ready? Now. A long time ago...
Now,
You forgot to say once upon a time.
Very well, Uncle Fester, very well. Once upon a time, a very long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, in a little village, there was this tiny little boy named Deedlebolt. A very good boy. And he knew the legend of Cousin Shy. Cousin Shy is the special spirit of Halloween. The spirit who carves happy smiles on a specially hidden pumpkin and leaves beautiful gifts at the feet of the Halloween scarecrow. And then there was one day when Deedlemoat wanted to find out if Cousin Shy was real. And so this little boy carved a mouth on the giant pumpkin. And guess what happened?
It talked! It talked!
Yes. And it said,
I'm the spirit of Cousin Shy. I belong to the whole world. You will never see me. But if children are very good, I will pay them a visit every Halloween. And if you leave a pumpkin in a very special place, I will carve it for you and leave gifts under your scarecrow.
And that's the story of Cousin Shy.
Hey, wait a minute. You forgot to say, and they lived happily ever after.
I forgot. Uncle Fester, you may say. I have to say goodbye to my big brother.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And they lived happily ever after.
Morticia, I'm not going. I should be telling that story, not Pancho.
Pancho never could tell that story as well as you, my dear.
Oh, I suppose so. Can you imagine forgetting once upon a time in a galaxy far, far away? Well, the bus for Tombstone waits for no man.
Wait a while and I'll get you there on my broom. It's the only way to fly. This is a test flight. Fly me, I'm Mother Frump. We really move our tail for you.
Take the bus.
Well, thanks for trying. Adios. Parting is such sweet sorrow. You think Shakespeare really said that?
Why not invite him to the party and ask him?
We can't do that. You said yourself, it's only family this year.
Don.
Tish, every moment away from you is an eternity. Every second an eon.
With all your luggage, I thought you'd use the station wagon.
Couldn't. You know how the children prefer it.
Such a good father. Darling, when will you return from your journey?
6 o'clock tomorrow. All right.
You too, kitty cat.
Goodbye, dear brother. Adiosito. I'll take care of everything
here. Au revoir, mon mari, mon cher.
Lunch! That's French! Stop the car! Camille! Camille!
French. Morticia. You must restrain yourself, por favor. I'm an Adams. Our blood. We have a code.
We.
Had.
No! Don't stop that!
Remember, Pancho, remember the code.
Yes. Si, si, si. The code.
Out of the way. That deal you made with this lodge worked perfect. With all that luggage, you'll be gone for weeks.
Suggestion. If he does come back, I would like to contract on him.
Suggestion under advice. Now, the Adams family is loaded. If everything goes as planned, we'll clear a nice million on this. Yeah. Maybe more.
Maybe more, eh?
I have a complication that's beginning to take form.
Well, give it to me when it's fact. I despise phrases like beginning to take form.
Well, I'm only saying that all of that gibberish that we're picking up from the Adams place could be cold.
Nah.
How else do you explain things like hide and boo and first-class snake?
First-degree snake.
Oh, those are just titles in his lodge.
Well, what about that ridiculous nonsense about Cousin Shy?
Huh? We're beginning to get some action in the second floor bedroom. Is that all of the room we can see?
Well, we couldn't get cameras everywhere. This is on telephoto, right from across the street, sir.
Uh-huh. Somebody's cutting roses off the stems. And throwing them away?
And keeping the stems. Explanation, please.
It could be visual code.
Oh,
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Thank you, Singh. Hello?
Cara mia, did you get the roses I sent?
Yes, the thorns are lovely.
They're American uglies. Let me tell you something, Morticia. Tombstone, Arizona is nothing without you.
What a lovely thing to say. Gomez, darling, you must excuse me. I have to go help Mama with the party menu.
It's a strange thing, but I can feel your presence all around me, like a cocoon. Somehow I'm able to picture you precisely as you are.
It's a wonderful faculty. Darling, don't worry about the party. Pancho and I are taking care of everything. Goodbye, mon mari glorieux.
Mon mari, Tish, that's French. You know what that does to me.
Gomez! Gomez!
Gomez!
Pancho?
Don't worry, dear brother. I'm taking care of everything. Adios.
It's so nice when a woman knows she's wanted by a man who can't have her.
Querida.
Your mother's sulking up in her room. Her room and fly recipe blew up last night. Her maid's helping me.
Dear mother, she has her heart set on flying before the moon's over Miami.
That'll be the day. Thank you, Lady Fingers.
Now, about the hors d'oeuvres. Not now, Gomez, darling, later. We'll need about 24 hopping eggs. I think a 4-inch hop is enough, don't you?
You get them jumping any higher than that and they hop right off the plate and people step on them.
Don't you hate to hear an egg scream?
How about molten eye of new pudding for dessert?
Enchanté. People like a pudding that can look up to them.
Enchanté. That's French.
Morticia, por favor, you know what that does to me.
Remember the code.
I remember it, but you have turned my heart to lava.
Isn't it interesting? Both brothers' emotions are triggered by French.
No, remember, I have the same trigger for Gaelic, Greek, and Sanskrit, and not to mention Swahili and Yiddish.
Mama, you've soaked poor Pancho.
Yeah. And I also cooled his lava.
Gesundheit.
I think I've broken down eye of the new pudding to mean either gun emplacement or beach bucket.
Well, it's time to enter the Adams house.
I'm not going. Just give the job to Mikey. He'll do anything.
Yeah. Mikey. Would you like going into the Adams house?
He likes it.
Hey, Mikey.
Approaching the front door, climbing up the steps. If I may be allowed a piece of editorial, this is a piece of cake.
County tax assessor. Would you tell Mrs. Adams that I'm here?
Wait here.
From where I'm standing, the rooms look weirder than we thought. There's a two-headed turtle, there's an 8-foot bear, and there's a fish mounted on the wall with a leg sticking out of his mouth and at like 10-foot.
Christmas and Easter bring wonderful treasures. How do you do, sir? I understand you've come to assess.
Yes, my name is Grimm.
Grimm? What a lovely name.
Somebody has cleaned the soot out of the chimney again. A beautiful 3-year collection gone pop.
Those were the days when you could get a sensitive chimney sweeper over, Mama. This is Mr. Grimm, the assessor. Show him the house, please.
He's in it. Very well. Come along.
Thank you, Mr. Grimm. Run along. If you'd like ribs for lunch, I'm sure Mama can dig up a spare whalebone for you. Hello? Oh, no. No, this year it's only family.
Oh, lady figures, while I think of it, add a pinch of knit blizzard to the moon bomb sauce and stir. Come on. Needs more stirring. Well, let's go, young man. Haven't you ever seen people working in a kitchen before?
And now in the kitchen, they've got two hands. One to answer the phone, and the other one to stir the soup. Soup!
You always talk to luggage.
Disgusting.
You strike me as a very weird young man. Well, come along. This is where we do the laundry. Keep a few old friends.
How nice. Your own cemetery?
Strictly family.
Oh.
Yes, this is damp enough. Excuse me a minute. Garter snakes. They don't grow them the way they used to. No spring. Why, you can't get them to even hold up a girl's stockings anymore. See what I mean? That's my eldest granddaughter. Wednesday seniors home. Feel free to look around.
Welcome home.
Thank you, Lurch. Handsome as ever. Thank you, Thing.
Wednesday, my dear child.
Mother.
Never say that we were false of heart, though absence seemed our flame to qualify.
Hello, Wednesday Junior. Hello, Pugsley Junior.
Hello, Wednesday Senior.
Hello, Wednesday. The dress needs letting out.
Ah, my niece. Home from Music Academy. Never say that we were false of heart, though absence seemed our flame to qualify.
Mother said that.
Two minds in a single sloth.
Gesundheit. I don't know what I was saying. Gesundheit.
I want to apologize to all of you. I almost gave up the broom and fly recipe. I was wrong. I forgot one of the old family mottos, never say die. Thank you. Well, back to the drawing board.
Thank you.
something for us, my child. Play something cheerful, like the blues.
Oh, better yet, Morticia, something light and gray.
Oh, the piccolo. That's your father's instrument. He's never without one.
May I have an A, Lurch? I shall now play for you the Mordant Bestiary by Johann Sebastian Schwinderholt.
That's what I call music with a sting. When you reach the animals, you are a true artist.
Operation Briefcase, over. Come in, Operation Briefcase, over. 20 minutes since I've heard from him. How are you coming on that costume?
The computer came up with this.
Now, those ringlets are all wrong. They should be stringier. Now, keep trying to get Mikey. We move tonight, and he hasn't even found the safe yet. I'm gonna go put on my costume.
Right. Little Bo Peep.
Out.
Do you realize that every time I move, the wind whistles up my drawers?
Get on that receiver, now!
Operation Briefcase. Come in, Operation Briefcase.
Will you holler when I get my pliers on the wisdom tooth in there? I can't see it because I'm out there. Lewis! How can he holler if you keep hugging him? You see?
Lewis.
Sir? I've got a terrible headache. I just got to get this tooth out. Point at it, will you please? Here, hold it. Point at it. Go ahead, point at it.
One. No. Two. Oh, this is so good.
You want to pull one?
Oh, no. I can't. I won't. Oh, no. You know what? Because I'm busy.
Oh.
I'm inspecting the house.
Oh.
I'm busy.
The house?
Yes.
Would you like to see the playroom?
The playroom?
Yeah.
Yes, by all means. Playroom. Everything's right here. Yes.
Hey, get away from me. Get away. Hey, get away.
Playroom?
Oh, sure.
What was that?
What was what? Oh, that's just old kitty cat.
He's a little bigger than a kitty cat.
Come on.
You know what that
is.
Playroom?
Yeah, sure. You got a headache or anything? Why don't you try the rock?
The rock?
Oh, yeah, it'll make your muscles sink. You'll make your feet fine. No,
please. I've had enough. I've seen enough. Let's go back upstairs.
Oh, you want to go upstairs?
Yes.
Well, let's take the shortcut.
Shortcut, absolutely, yes. Let's go.
Oh, wait a minute. Don't step on kitty cat's tail.
Come on, look like a guy that would step on kitty cat's tail.
Hey,
come
on, you stepped on kitty cat's tail.
Big kitty cat, bigger than a house kitty cat, MGM kitty cat. Please don't sit down and talk about it. Oh, my head.
Oh, you got a headache?
Yeah.
I'll get you a little juice.
Oh, some juice, yes, some juice.
Yeah.
I'll let you go, sir. Please let me go.
We get the weirdest people in here.
Dr. Adam.
Adams, Pugsley Senior is home.
My nephew, the doctor.
Pugsley, my dear son, welcome home from Nairobi Medical School.
Dr. Kildare never looked better. Ungawa.
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 My dear Mr. Grimm, I'm afraid I forgot you were here. Are you well?
You're not looking very well. Perhaps El Senor Adams, Dr. Adams.
Yes.
Let him take a look at you. Por favor, de acostarse aquí.
Here you are. I don't know what happened to him, but he saw a kitty cat down here. And something must have happened.
Doesn't our Dr. Adams have a lovely bedside manner?
I need a doctor. I always look this way.
I'm all right.
I'm good. I'm good.
I'm good.
This world is sure full of weird people.
Hey, dear, I congratulate you. That's the most miraculous recovery I've ever seen.
Thank you, Mother. I owe it all to Dr. Mugumbo.
Dear Dr. Mugumbo, your father and I haven't seen him for years. How is he?
Great. Have a look.
Ah, a perfect likeness. And how sweet of you to carry his picture.
Haven't you raised him yet? Where's the safe?
Captain, it'll be Mikey bad boy. Mikey step on tail of kitty cat. Kitty cat, I don't know, I'm talking cat. There's a bush that chokes people, and there's a flower that eats handkerchief, and there's a bald-headed guy who completely out of his mind. He wanted to fix my back by putting me on a rack.
Where's the safe?
There's a servant, a man, and a woman. Nobody, just hands. One for the phone, one to stir the soup. I'm going to leave. I'm quitting. I'm going home, Mommy. I'm going to go out of the I don't know.
Come back here. Orlando is no good to us in the condition he's in.
Wait till you hear, till you see the girl who plays the music, and there's no music. That's a beaut. Oh, that's a good one. You want to see that one?
I want to show you something.
Just thinking, I wonder what put our little friend into such a state of shock.
Forget about him. Look at this.
What?
Well, show him.
You're talking to me?
Please.
Goodbye. Well, on second thought, we have all this protection.
Now, this is the thing that's going to make it all work. Watch.
Ah, mon cher. Mon mari.
French. Smoke French. Querida. Speak some more. And, save some for the party. Okay?
Okay.
Masks.
Very okay.
Christmas and Easter bring wonderful treasures, but spirits and pumpkins bring far greater pleasure.
Bravo!
How thrilled your face must be to be so near that golden throat.
Have you seen your children's costumes? It'll be dark in an hour, and look what they're wearing.
Morticia,
mustn't stare.
They're very different children, darlings.
Have a good time at the party, anyway.
I've never seen Wednesday look so plain.
Be sure and wear a mask, darling.
This one really tears it.
Now that's disgusting.
And you call yourself a doctor? Oh, I'm sorry, my son.
All right, go and get dressed proper for the party.
That's all part of today's world. Do you know Pugsley Sr. told me earlier that he'd gone to the beach in the sunlight? Yes, he said he's getting a tan. It's all the rage at his school.
Schools? No discipline today.
I haven't told you about Wednesday yet. She wants a Kawasaki.
Well, there I can relieve your mind, Morticia. Our family is very partial to mixed marriages.
It's a motorcycle. Did you have a cake in the oven, Mama?
It's that woman again. That's my kitchen, not an airport.
You've got to admit, I'm starting to get altitude.
I know you'll do it.
Look who's back. Old Big Eyes. He's not supposed to be back yet.
Well, that means we go to Plan B. Plan B.
I'm home!
Where is everybody?
Oh, yes, Lurch. It's a beautiful costume, but where is everybody?
Four fingernails in a blip.
Cousin It, with that hat, nobody will recognize you.
Where's the family?
Warm lip and nothing to go.
Trimming a scarecrow without me?
Oh, show me.
Time for all good little bats to be in bed. Ah, I think the scarecrow needs a few more cobwebs on his right arm. Get your spider, Wednesday Jr.
Yes, Mother. Thank you, Thing. Okay, Homer, spin.
You know something, Morticia? There is nothing like a family gather around the old Halloween scarecrow.
Yes, and if Cousin Shy comes this year, there'll be gifts and love and Halloween carols.
Yes. Listen, everybody. I think the youngest should put the head on top of the scarecrow. That means you, Wednesday, and up you go.
Unhand that child. A man goes a serpenting and returns to find his place usurped by a brother. A brother who lifts his child up to put a head on a scarecrow?
Well, after all, you weren't here, old man.
That's true, Momelli.
Monnerie. It's French. Morticia.
Usurped. Usurped.
Pancho, really? I don't like to criticize, but I'm afraid your Adam's coat is wearing thin. Gomez?
Only go, Pepita.
Cousin It.
Morning.
A man comes home and finds himself an outcast. What's a man to do?
Gormit Nerdus, any better, much.
You can say that. You're a bachelor. Morticia's the only woman in my life.
Why aren't you really about her?
Calling me a pea brain is not a solution. You're right. It's the old paternal rejection syndrome. Cousin Shy won't respect me if I sulk.
Double limits, it's good to see you.
You're right. I should think of the children and Halloween. Yeah. Thank you, Cousin It. What are you anyway?
I'm no good, Robert!
Oh, yes, you're all men, of course.
Oh, That's naughty, okay.
Hello, family.
My love.
Up you go, Wednesday Junior.
Oh, I love it when you get your head on straight, Gomez.
Well, let's just hope the scarecrow does the same.
Sister dear, any interesting men here?
Poncho's upstairs.
Say no more.
Okay. Now I'll go in with the others. You two go around the back and through the kitchen. Now remember, you look like the host, so play it that way. Oh, go on, go on.
Must be the Boston branch of the family.
Welcome. Our house is your house.
We like to think so.
Hey, taste this, Morticia. Oh, taste it. It's the icing for the salamander cake. Enough creosote. Perfect. Are you sure? The recipe says it's got to be strong enough to stun a canary. It's perfect.
Not enough cyanide, Mama.
I don't like to criticize, dear, but it's not very stunning.
Make up your mind, girl. 1 minute it's perfect, the next minute it's flat.
Temper, Mama. Temper.
Isn't the music lovely? And doesn't Cousin Sloth play a melodic banjo?
Yes, and look at Wednesday Senior.
What talent.
Fantastic. Makes you want to sit in. Where's your boy? Why don't you dance?
Yes, pick some lovely lady. After all, Halloween is a democratic and romantic holiday. You'll do better without the cowl. Let the ladies see your handsome face.
I found him! I found him! He was hiding.
I was not hiding. I was meditating.
In the dumbwaiter?
Sounds reasonable.
Let's dance.
Oh. It's a new step.
Shall we, my dear?
Time is now. We have mingled. We have danced.
You call this dancing? I call it plowing.
Everything I want you to do is...
No! I mean, no thanks. No, I don't mean no thanks. I mean no!
I want those two taken care of. I'll need about an hour. Well, go on!
You Boston Adams really know how to give a lift to a party.
Why aren't you dancing with Morticia?
Why aren't you dancing with Gomez?
You always have big eyes for Morticia.
You've always had big eyes for him.
Well, then why aren't you dancing with her?
I will.
Me too.
Now, look, we'd better split up. You take the second floor, you take this floor, and I'll check below. And remember, the safe could be anywhere.
Morticia, dance.
Come on, Gomez, let's go.
Wait a minute. Come back here. Fools. The whole project is way off schedule.
We're to try and get loose. Is that the game? This Boston branch is extremely innovative, Kevin.
They bulge nicely, too.
We used to duck for apples, but I like their game much better. In a way, we've never been closer.
I wonder if the rules permit us to try and escape. I must help Mama with the hors d'oeuvres.
Hors d'oeuvres, dish, that's French. Oh, speak some more. This is so good, I want to get loose. I know what, we'll play the old piccolo game. I still have my card in Local 802. We are way off schedule. Now, did you dispose of them?
They're not going anywhere.
Oh, Mr. Adams.
We loved your game. But if you'll excuse me, I have to go and see Mama about the the refreshments.
Cousin, did she speak French? Are you sure? We have a similar game in our part of the country. It's called Dunk and Thrash. Only you play it in a swamp.
In a swamp.
Or in muck and mire, if you prefer. It's a matter of taste. See you later.
Get him. And this time I don't want any excuses.
What about the woman?
She's gonna be busy in the kitchen. Now remember, I'll need a full hour. Go on, get him.
Hello, Thing. Any news? Oh, well, keep me posted. By the way, nice costume. Having a nice time at the party? Again? Say, why not play Eastern Rules this time? That's where you blindfold the contestants. It's really fun.
Cousin!
You are so pliant tonight, Morticia, and so affectionate.
And why not, mon cher?
It's French. Aren't you going to stop me?
May not.
That does it.
Now I want you to go upstairs. Most people keep their jewels in the bedroom. The real Morticia is in the kitchen. I have taken care of Gomez for keeps. Go, go, go.
I see you've had assertiveness training. I admire that.
Especially within the family.
It's cozy, but it inhibits doing push-ups. Well, ready or not, here I come.
Some hors d'oeuvres. These creep, these hop, and these just lie there. I'm sure if you have the family dexterity, you can catch a hopping egg on the first hop. Ready? Go. Oh, you missed. Do be careful where you step, Mr. Adams. I hate to hear an egg scream.
Too bad. It was a good egg. I can see you're upset, but look at it this way. Life is short in the hors d'oeuvre jungle.
Yes, well, excuse me.
I enjoyed playing the game. Let's play it again sometime soon. When I said soon, I didn't have this in mind, gentlemen. You see, the witching hour is approaching, and before Cousin Shy arrives, the children have to be put to bed. And somebody has to carve the crocodile. This game is getting complicated. It goes against the grain, but I'm afraid I'm gonna have to cheat a bit. Thing? Sorry to take you away from the party. Oh, thanks a lot, old boy. The piccolo, please.
Where's your partner?
Upstairs.
All right. She's in the way. Take care of her. Go dance with her. I've taken care of Gomez for keeps again. That leaves me free to poke around down here. Go on, go on, go on.
Aha! There you are!
Just scream.
No more games, eh, Mr. Adams? I have my guest to think of. Aha! I believe my good news has arrived.
Pardon me?
Thank you, Payne. I'm not exalted Grand Serpent, Thing. Not even first-degree snake. Been reduced to worm. Second class.
Put the children to bed. Your mask is very becoming, Gomez. You've learned a few new steps in Tombstone, Arizona, mon cher.
That's French.
Gomez!
What, Tisha?
wait to continue our dance. You're so pliant, so affectionate, so nuzzly.
Sweet nuzzly. When, Montclair?
That's French.
If you don't remember the code, I shall become very cross with you.
I'm a second-class worm. Stranger kisses my wife. Brother kisses my wife. Wearing my clothes. Smoking my cigars. To be or not to be. Not to be. That is the answer.
Poor Gomez. What a blow. Well, his nerves must be shot. Oh, there you are. I know just what you need. There, doesn't that feel better?
No, get me off of here.
Gomez, how would you like to be 6'2"? You know, I think that Morticia would really like that.
Oh, you've got the wrong man. I'm just a guest here. Take off my mask and then see.
An imposter! By Jupiter! Well, I'll get you out of there right away. That's the first mistake I ever made on the rock. If I make you too tall, I can arrange to shorten you. And if your socks are straight, I'll be very happy to knit you new pants. If you prefer, I can lengthen your pants.
Morticia, I was looking for you. I wanted to apologize for almost breaking the code while we were dancing.
Oh, Montoya.
Montoya? Will you be cross with me?
May no.
May no? My apologies, brother. My blood overcame the code.
You were a cad, sir, and I should thrash you. Worm has no standing. No, no. Not even with his wife.
You are depressed, mon ami, mon cher.
Mon cher. He gave me permission, brother.
Shall be pistols at dawn, sir.
Are you quite finished?
I was upset. I've been reduced to worm by my lodge.
Anyway, I knew it wasn't you. It didn't taste right.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're not the grand exalted serpent, mon cher.
Mon cher, that's French.
Look, you're steaming lips off my wife.
But rather, my blood is still percolating.
Percolating? This is my wife, not Mrs. Olson.
I'll send you a nice letter of apologies when this is all over.
If you can still write.
When you've got it, you've got it.
Give me the salamander sauce, lady fingers.
She's gone to the party, Mama.
You just can't get reliable help these days.
Will you be flying by the witching hour, Mother?
Like a 747.
Well, keep the noise low. You know how the neighbors complain.
Look, you don't appeal to me. Where are we going?
Tower.
The tower? No, I don't. Look, I'm not that kind of a girl. No, I don't want to go to the tower. I've never done this sort of thing before. Please, stop it, will you?
How?
Mm-hmm.
getting out of here.
Come back here! Come back here! This goes on your unemployment record!
If you want something done, you've got to do it yourself.
We're almost there. Hold it. Just a minute. Oh. Oh. I'll be right there. Oh. One more bubble. Oh. Oh, hold it! Hold it! I have to get the launching pad! Right, take it easy, we're not there yet! All right, count down. 3, 2, 1, count!
Look, if you let me go, I'll buy you a pterodactyl.
Shh, frightened pterodactyl.
You know something, sir? I know just what you need. You need to relax, sir.
This is a rock.
It will relieve your tension. You need it.
Oh, please. I give up. I'll confess. Oh, please don't do it anymore. I'll confess to everything.
Don't ask me. You'll have to ask Cousin Shy.
Cousin Shy?
Yeah, I'm getting suspected. Cousin Shy is turning the rock.
Cousin Shy?
Yeah, tell him.
Wherever you are, I'll give up. I confess my name is Lafferty. I am a crook. Oh, yes, a very big crook. Oh!
And a very special holiday for the Adams family. Everyone here is a relative.
I'm sorry you're mistaken, Morticia. These two aren't.
Well, Bones Lafferty. And Louis the Lord?
Well, you must be mistaken, officer. These are members of our family.
No. We just said that. We're not members. There was a lion in the basement, and had a leaf right out the window.
There was no light here. It was a pterodactyl. Oh, please, Fuzzy, take us away. Take us away, Fuzzy, please. I'll never get away from you.
feeling they weren't relatives. Their New England accent was deplorable.
The witching hour. It's time to wake the children and,
I'll do it, big brother.
Wait a minute. It's a father's job.
Darling, why don't you see if Cousin Shy has carved the pumpkin yet? Morbid. Be of good cheer.
Morticia, he's here. Cousin Shy is here.
Yes, I feel the chill. Lovely.
I just saw him carving a pumpkin.
Come, we must go to the children.
Yes.
Seek out of me. A father has a special feeling on a night like this. He remembers his children's first Halloween.
Children?
Pancho's in there with my children.
Darling, you must remember he has no children of his own.
Nor a wife of his own. How? What's he saying?
Children, the wishing hour is here.
How dare the man? He has no right.
Gomez, wait.
Let me tell you something. This is the way it used to be when your papa and I were little boys. I was little and dumb, and he was older and very, very good to me. I'll never forget that. He is a fine man, your father.
You see, Caramia, I always told you my brother's an exceptional person.
Pancho, get the children dressed. We'll all go to the tower.
Now that's the Halloween spirit.
Got it.
Come, we'll all sing to Cousin Shy on this joyful and solemn occasion.
Christmas and Easter bring wonderful treasures, but spirits and pumpkins bring far greater pleasures. Phantoms and ghosts make wonderful hosts, and every year they convene to wish you a merry, creepy Halloween. Are always together. Spiders spin cobwebs in overcast weather. Cauldrons are brewing and banshees are doing a weird and ghastly routine to wish you a merry, creepy Halloween. This is the night of heavenly fright. Witches on broomsticks are up to their tricks, and poltergeists trail to the moon, which looks like a silver balloon. Frankenstein's monster is having a ball, scaring the goblins right off of the wall. Boogeymen prance at our favorite dance, and children are king and queen. They wish you a merry, creepy Halloween.
Here.
only cousin shy parts a cobweb like that. Blood cold, doesn't it?
It's a lovely feeling. Wednesday Senior, you may turn on the light.
I'm telling you, I'm going to open my present. Get out of my way, I'm going to open my present.
Merry Halloween! Happy Halloween, everybody!
Beautiful Halloween, Carita. Perfect day, perfect marriage.
Amazing with so many divorces.
Yes, lovers should try divorce first. And if it doesn't work, then marry.
I'll accept it with you, Roche.
Tish, that's French.
Yes, I know.
Tish.
Come
here. Tish.
Tonight?
Yes.
Tonight belongs to Cousin Shy and the children.
So it does. So it does.
This is the night of heavenly fright. Witches on broomsticks are up to their tricks, and poltergeists trail to the moon, which looks like a silver balloon. Frankenstein's monster is having a ball, scaring the goblins right off of the wall. Bogeyman Ransom are favorite cats, and children are king and queen. They wish you a merry, creepy Halloween.